Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Apple after the tech giant reported fiscal second quarter results, the top downbeat estimates. It also unveiled a record share buyback program worth $110 billion, the largest in U.S. history. Apple shares rose 6% in the pre-market. Also in focus, shares of Paramount. The Wall Street Journal reported Sony Pictures and Apollo Global Management have made a $26 billion cash offer to buy Paramount. The American media conglomerate is slightly up before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Société Générale after it posted a decline in profit in the first quarter. Shares of the French bank slumped 5% after rising in early trading.
Asian markets ended the week mostly higher on muted volumes, with Japanese and Chinese markets closed for a holiday. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led gains, jumping 1.5% for its ninth straight day of gains. That's the index's longest winning streak in over 6 years. Here at home, Philippine shares closed out the week on the back foot, with the main index closing lower for a third straight session and posting its fifth weekly loss.
On a more regional basis, Asian currencies have weakened significantly against the dollar as rate cuts in the U.S. keeps getting pushed back. But locally, we saw a failed break above the resistance at 6750 last week. So this has triggered some profit taking in the local market. And we're also seeing some caution ahead of major economic data releases next week, such as the inflation print on Tuesday and the GDP on Thursday. So. And also, the geopolitical risk is also not helping the sentiment.
Also in the spotlight, the Japanese yen, which capped off a volatile week, extending its gains against the U.S. dollar. It touched a high of 152 to the dollar in Asian trade, having started the week at a 34-year low of 160, following suspected intervention by Japanese authorities twice this week. Filipino authorities eyeing another diplomatic protest against China over its supposed targeting of the Philippine flag in its recent water cannon attack. The Philippine flag took a direct hit from the Chinese Coast Guard's water cannoning during Tuesday's supply mission to Panatag Shoal. Manila has lodged over 150 diplomatic protests against Beijing under the Marcos administration.
We have to investigate when an incident happens in the waters. We have to have an official report coming from PCG, from other agencies, and also from the National Task Force. The report becomes a basis for the action that will be taken, whether it will be a protest, a summoning, or what.
In a recent statement, China's embassy alleged the Philippines violated so-called temporary special arrangements made in 2016. The Philippine government has repeatedly denied making any deals with China regarding the West Philippine Sea.